So, almost every time I leave the house, I have some weird kind of shit happen to me. Like, whether it's someone approaching me wanting to practice their English, or someone taking photos of me, or I don't know. Today was the worst by far. I was walking down into Ikebukuro Metro on the escalator, and I know there was someone behind me, no big deal. I went down one escalator, I went down the next escalator, and this guy was standing. There was no one else around. This guy was standing on the step behind me, and normal, like, escalator etiquette is you leave a step and you go on the next one. Give the person in front of you some, you know, some space. And he didn't. And he, like, kind of. I thought he was going around me to pass, but he, like, didn't. I had this massive bag in my hand, and he come and just, like, bumped me and, like, pushed my bag. And I just turned around, like, what the fuck? And, I don't know. That's kind of when I first noticed him, so I don't know how long he'd been following me for. But I got down the escalator into the station, and I started to walk one direction and noticed, like, this guy is right behind me. So I stopped, pretended to look at a shop. He stood maybe 2 meters behind me, and then I started to walk in the opposite direction. He was there again, 1 or 2 meters behind me, like, literally breathing down my neck. And I started to freak out, and, my boyfriend is at work, so I called my friend Sophie, and I was like, girl, like, this guy is following me. She's like, oh my god, where are you? And I was like, in Ikebukuro Station, and I was talking about him. I'm like, this creep is following me. I explained to her what happened on the escalator. He could have heard everything, absolutely everything. He was breathing down my neck, and I was walking quickly, and he was very quick to follow. And I was on the phone talking about him, and I was literally zigzagging, like walking this way for 5 meters, walking that way for 5 meters, and this guy followed me like every step of the way. And Sophie was just like, get to like a station master, get to a station guard. And I was like, oh, I can't find any. So I get to my ticket gates, and right next to my ticket gates is the station master, the station office. So I'm on the phone to her, just like, oh my god. I walk up, I stand out front of the station office, and he goes there, and I'm looking at him, and he hides behind the pole, and I'm like, telling her, like, yeah, he's still there. And he goes around the other side, and I'm like, oh, I've lost him. And he comes back around and pokes his head around, and he's still staring at me. I'm like, yeah, girl, he's still there. And she's like, okay, get into the station office. So I decide to go through my ticket gates and walk around and stand at the station office, and then by the time I look back, he's gone. But I'm like, this guy has a bright orange t-shirt on, a fucking fedora, he's like pale and washed out, he's not like overweight or anything, he's just like, I don't know, a creepy looking Japanese dude. And he's just like fucking following me. He doesn't talk to me. He doesn't take pictures of me. I don't understand what he was doing. Like, I don't look good today. I have no makeup on. I have a loose dress on. Like, I'm not looking. I haven't washed my hair in like a week. I'm not looking good today at all. And I've got, like, I'm on the phone. Like, I've got all my shopping bags. Like, why? 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 What's the point? Like, why are you following me? Oh. It's so frustrating. Like, I have anxiety. That's no secret. I post about it all the time. I already had such anxiety leaving the house today, and then, like, this shit happens to me. I'm already, like, because every time, as I said, every time I leave the house, someone approaches me or talks to me or is staring at me and taking pictures of me. Ever since I came to Japan in 2015, people have been taking pictures of me, whether it's young girls or old men. Like, people always fucking take pictures of me, whether I look good or bad, like I'm covered head to toe with a fucking face mask on, or I'm showing my shoulders. People always take pictures of me, and I'm not meaning to sound vain or up myself or anything. They do. They just do. They take pictures of Storm too. All of my girlfriends, people, like, they get pictures taken of them. It's just, you know, it's just what people here in Japan do. And I already have such anxiety leaving the house because that happens to me all the time. And then this happens to me. And then, I'm like, oh, I tell, like, Sophie, my girlfriend, I'm like, on the phone because I've walked through, I'm about to get on the train. I'm like, no, I don't see him. She's like, we'll come meet you at the station. I'm like, oh no, it's fine, it's whatever. So I get out of the station, like, that guy's not there, but I'm charging my IC card and then I'm like putting my wallet back in and I have my headphones in, listen to my music, and some old guy comes past and I swear he says Kira-chan, and I'm like, oh, like, I don't know why this old dude would have known who I was, but I was like, what? And he goes, high touch. And I'm like, what? So I like high five him and he just like waves and I'm like, what is going on? And then he starts speaking to me in full Japanese. I have my music up all the way. And at this point, I'm just like, I'm not even gonna try to speak to you. I'm like, I just don't speak Japanese. I'm just like, I don't speak Japanese. I don't speak Japanese. I do speak a little Japanese. But at this point, I just couldn't be bothered. I'm like, I just don't speak Japanese. And he was like, so confused. And I was like, oh, I'm not in the mood to be harassed by anyone else, so I just like walked away. But like, every time I leave the house, I'm super super aware of every man around me, which is silly because like back in Australia I was known as the cutthroat bitch. I was so rude to any guy that even breathed in my direction. All my girlfriends knew it. Like, no matter where we were, if a guy looked at us, I'd be like, no, don't even bother, don't approach us, don't talk to us, don't blink in our direction, no, it's not gonna happen. I was so fucking rude all the time back then, and I come to Japan because I love Japanese people. Like, every Japanese person I've ever met is so kind and polite, and so I come here and I'm like, you know, I embrace how polite Japanese people are, and it's like one of, if not the most safest country in the world. There is like, there's barely a lower class, there's no drugs around here, like the crime rate is ridiculously low, but there is so many creeps out here, like there really is, and I just, gives me anxiety every time I leave the house. And when something like this happens, it may not seem like a big deal to you, but when you're in like the safest country of ever and you get stalked within a meter all around a train station and without like contact, it's just like, why? Like, why? It's not just me, it happens to like almost all of my girlfriends, young or old. Everyone always gets like harassed. Like, if someone wants to practice their English on me, I'm more than likely happy to oblige and to, you know, have a small talk conversation. But this guy didn't anything, he just followed me around. But I don't know, I'm sure that these guys are all so harmless. The population here is 99% Japanese, so you know, it's not like I'm so worried or anything, but it's just like, why? Just leave me alone, just let me run my errands, just let me go about my day, just leave me alone, leave Kira alone. I needed to vent. I put my headphones in because I don't want anyone to talk to me, but then I feel like having my headphones in, like, I don't know, all my senses aren't super aware, so like I don't really pay attention to what's going on around me, so it's like damned if you do, damned if you don't. But yeah, I'm gonna go. I don't know. Bye.